Hello everyone, welcome back to our channel. Today's topic is GPCR cAMP signaling. How do cells communicate with each other and respond to different signals? One way is by using molecules called second messengers, which relay the signal from the cell surface to the inside of the cell. One of the most common second messengers is cyclic AMP or cAMP in short. Let's see how cAMP works in a signaling pathway. First, an intracellular signal molecule such as hormone, neurotransmitter, or light binds to a receptor on the cell membrane. This receptor is called a G protein coupled receptor or GPCR because it activates a G protein inside the cell. The G protein has three subunits, alpha, beta, and gamma. When the receptor is activated, the alpha subunit exchanges its bound GTP for GTP and separates from the beta and gamma subunits. The alpha subunit then binds to an enzyme called adenylyl cyclase, which is embedded in the cell membrane. Adenylyl cyclase converts ATP, the energy currency of the cell, into cAMP. This increases the concentration of cAMP in the cytosol, which triggers the next step in the signaling pathway. cAMP activates a protein kinase called pKa, which stands for cyclic AMP-dependent protein kinase. A protein kinase is an enzyme that adds phosphate groups to other proteins, changing their shape and activity. pKa is composed of two catalytic subunits which carry out the phosphorylation and two regulatory subunits which bind to cAMP and control the activity of catalytic subunits. When cAMP binds to the regulatory subunits, they change their shape and releases the catalytic subunit which are now free to phosphorylate their target proteins. These target proteins can be either intracellular signaling proteins, which amplify or modify the signal, or effector proteins, which carry out the final response of the cell. One example of an effector protein is CREB or CREB, which stands for cAMP response element binding protein. pKa can then enter the nucleus, where they phosphorylate the transcription regulatory protein CREB. CREB is a transcription factor, which means it can bind to DNA and regulate gene expression. When pKa phosphorylates CREB, it activates its ability to bind to a specific DNA sequence called the cAMP response element or CRE. CREB then recruits another protein called CBP, which stands for CREB binding protein. CBP is a co-activator, which means it helps CREB to stimulate the transcription of the genes that are controlled by CRE. By activating CREB, cAMP can regulate the expression of many genes that are involved in various cellular processes such as metabolism, growth, and differentiation.